the different models of the Bird scooters that you see out on the streets. You can see behind me that we've got a few different Birds set up, and we're gonna go in depth and look at some details today. Before the first time you ride a Bird, you'll wanna know where the throttle and of course where the brakes are located so you don't run into a tree. After a little kickstart, slowly hit the throttle so that you can find a comfortable speed to ride at just to get started. So Birds can roll over small bumps, cracks, and gaps, but you definitely want to slow down when you're coming across any type of uneven terrain and make sure that you want to avoid any obstacles, roll straight over anything that you might see on the ground in front of you. All Birds have regenerative anti-lock brakes on the front, which means that whenever you let off the throttle, you're actually charging the scooter just like you would be in a hybrid or electric vehicle. Additionally, there are a couple mechanical rear brakes that you can also use to slow down and come to a complete stop. So most of the Bird fleet is based off of two different scooter models. So first, let's take a look at the first Bird model to hit the streets, the Xiaomi M365. This scooter is made by a Chinese electronics company, mostly known for its cell phones, but apparently they're making scooters now. And you can actually even buy your very own M365 online if you want to. But here today, we've got a bunch of Birds behind us. In terms of the hardware, Bird actually uses two main varieties that we're gonna talk about today, Brain Birds and Brainless Birds. Some of the earliest Birds to hit the streets were actually foldable, but these days, all of the Bird scooters are actually fixed and you can't fold them. You can only kind of use them as is. The M365 weighs about 27 pounds and has a top speed of 15 miles per hour, which is pretty damn fast. The maximum range is just over 18 miles, but obviously it depends on your driving terrain, your style, your driving style, and also, of course, your weight and things like that. The throttle for the M365 is right there on the handlebar. On the left handlebar is the rear mechanical brake. Now, the sleek Brainless Bird, which you see right here, communicates only through Bluetooth. That means that the location information updates only when someone nearby is using the Bird app and it can transmit GPS through the phone. So for chargers and even riders, that means that these Brainless Birds can sometimes be a little bit harder to find since they're more likely to move without the app updating the location accurately. You know, another negative thing that we've seen with the Brainless Birds is that they currently lock after a certain amount of time. So if you're a charger and you capture one of these Birds, it'll actually lock after a certain amount of time. So if you're moving them between the street and your home or your car, you're gonna have to continually go into the app and unlock each Bird just to be able to roll it around. The Brainless Birds do have a power button on top though, which can sometimes allow you to communicate with a Bird when all else fails. Now we're gonna have Ezra come in and help us take a look at the Brain Bird.
Now on the flip side is the Brain Bird. These Birds have a small boxy unit on top of the handlebars which transmits GPS data. The Brain Birds are less likely to get lost because they are transmitting their location on a regular basis, whether or not someone nearby is using the Bird app. Now Brain Birds ride just the same as Brainless Birds, and one nice thing for chargers is that they remain unlocked after capture until we release them, so we can roll them and ride them without having to constantly unlock them throughout the course of our charging duties. Now with the Brain on top, there is no power button on these Brain Birds. A less common version of the M365 you might see is what's called the Albino Bird, or sometimes the Stormtrooper Bird, and that has the white riding deck, but is otherwise the same as other M365 Birds that you see on the road. Now the newest Birds we've been seeing on the streets are what we're gonna be calling the ES2. And these do have some bright blue ground effects that help riders and chargers alike find them at night, which is really, really cool. And those blue lights are what you see on the Bird version, but they can also be set to other colors on the consumer model. Now these Birds are the ES2, like I mentioned. The full name is the Segway Kick Scooter ES2, and these are made by another Chinese company called Ninebot and are equipped with a digital display that shows speed in miles per hour and battery level, which is nice. You can also turn the scooter off using the power button and in some cases even adjust the maximum speed. Now I'm sure you all remember Segway, the preferred transportation for mall cops everywhere. Ninebot actually bought Segway in 2015, and interestingly enough, Xiaomi, which makes the M365 we showed you earlier, is a major investor in Ninebot. So you'll see similarities and differences between the ES2 and the M365 as the two companies seem to both compete with each other and work together at the same time. Now, like the M365, the ES2 also weighs around 27 pounds but has a slightly lower range of 15 miles. The throttle for the ES2 is on the right handlebar, but the braking system is a little bit different. The thumb lever on the left handlebar actually operates the anti-lock front brake, and the rear mechanical brake is engaged by stepping directly on it. For now, the ES2s we've seen in the wild are similar to the Brainless Birds in that they only seem to connect to Bluetooth. And like the Brainless M365s, the ES2 can be powered off in a pinch. Now when it comes to charging, you can actually use the same power supplies to charge all of the birds we're looking at today. The ES2 does have a lower range and smaller battery than the M365, but a positive is that it charges much faster. A full charge on the ES2 should take about 3.5 hours versus 5.5 hours with the M365. Now keep in mind that most birds chargers pick up won't have fully depleted batteries, so charging times will normally be much lower than these estimates.
All right, so we've talked about the scooters a lot, but let's get to the fun part and let's do some riding. Let's hit the road. All right, I'm back, guys, and Ezra, I'm curious to know, what do you think about the Bird scooters? What's your favorite model?
So when I first started charging and riding birds, you know, it was all about the M365. Now these ES2s are pretty new, but I gotta say, they're really growing on me. They're really easy to carry around because you don't have the brakes sticking out on the bottom, which is really nice. And the deck isn't really heavy because the weight is concentrated more in the neck where the battery is. So I'm really digging the new ones, I gotta be honest.
Yeah, I mean, that's one of the cool things about the new ES2s is that I know the battery is actually in the vertical column, so it's in a little bit different position. It seems a lot more stable. There are a lot less exposed wires. And I know for me as a charger, the first time I saw a new bird, the ES2, out on the streets, it was pretty cool because it was a huge blue light and it was very easy to spot. And, you know, I don't know that it helps riders so much during the day because you can't see the light during the day and it's off, but at night it definitely makes it easy for chargers. And I think they just look a little bit more sleek.
I would definitely agree. You know, they're sleeker. It's version 2.0 when it comes down to it. You know, we discussed how these companies have an interesting relationship, but they've obviously worked together in some respects to improve on the M365, which is an awesome scooter, but to make it even better into the ES2 that we see now. So another difference that we talked about between the M365 and the newer ES2 is the tires, how they roll over things. So the M365 does have air-filled tires, and those tires are what's gonna be what absorbs the shock from the cracks and the bumps that you go over when you're riding. The ES2 is a little bit different. The tires are actually solid tires, so they can't get flat, which is nice from a maintenance perspective. And then in place of the air that would normally cushion the bird, there's actually a small suspension at the bottom of the ES2. So it's a different system and it'll give just a bit of a different ride.
So there's one thing that you missed though, Ezra. Do you know what that is?
I don't know.
The M365s actually have a little bell. Both scooters actually also have lights at the front. So if you are riding at dusk or at night, the lights do come on automatically and you can kind of at least see. You know, they're not perfect, but they definitely light up a little bit of the way in front of you. So you can definitely tell on the new bird, the ES2, that they've made some modifications. There are a lot less exposed wires. So the brake lines, the acceleration, the power cords, there's nothing sticking out, nothing that can be snipped by some hooligans or anything like that. And it just seems to overall be a definite improvement on the M365 when it comes to kind of design and even maybe aesthetics. So one thing I've noticed from riding both the M365 and the ES2 is that if you're riding for a long time without having to brake, without having to come to a stop, your right hand can actually get a little bit tired holding down the throttle for 5, 10, 15, even 20 minutes, if you're going down a straight path. So it definitely would be cool if they added some type of cruise control in the future. What do you think about that?
Cruise control would be cool. I mean, I think the most important thing is safety, so as long as they implement it with that in mind, that would definitely be nice.
These scooters are literally, I mean, they've been around for a while, but they've only been being used by Bird for a few months, right, really? And so we're sort of at the very beginning of a long race, and I think we're gonna see a ton of hardware improvements, a ton of software improvements on, you know, the scooters in general, but I think that, you know, we have these top speed limitations in certain areas, but I think going up hills is gonna get better, the battery charge is gonna stay longer, so there are a lot of improvements that I think we're gonna see for sure on these scooters. All right, guys, hope you enjoyed this video. video going over the different models of the Bird scooter. Thank you, Ezra, for joining me. And until next time, we'll see you guys out there on the road. Scoot safe. If you guys notice any differences, any questions about different models, or you've seen some features out there on the road that we didn't mention, don't hesitate to leave a comment below. Give this video a thumbs up if you liked it, and subscribe to the channel. All right, take care, and safe riding.
Happy charging.
Oh, Scoot, you have two? Oh, only one left. All right, Ezra, what else do you want? Just surprise them.
Whatever's clever. How about a double lemon, cherry explosion, one of those?
No more. Out.
Man, you guys are out
watermelon.
Of a lot of
stuff.
Finish.
Do you have any kind of fruit?
I have these ones.
The fruit?
Something fruity, like a popsicle type thing. What do you got? Okay.
Watermelon, please. Nice.
Sandia.
Can I trade? I like those better. I didn't know you had those. Is that okay if I trade?
Thank you.
Strawberry.